This week on Wildcat News, we ask if students believe West success was beneficial. We find out where our seniors are headed, and we meet our Student Volunteer of the Year. All these stories and more are coming up because Wildcat News starts now. Good morning, West Johnston. I'm Hannah Creech. Our schedule was a little bit different this year due to West success. Students have different feelings about how it went. Mason Butcher reports.
West success is a program that was implemented at the beginning of the school year. As this is a new program, students have different opinions on how it's going. Sophomore Ethan Brinkley believes it's a puzzling process.
I think it made the schedule almost a little bit more hectic because you have to go from first block to third block to second block back to third block. I think sometimes it can be really confusing.
Senior Emily Godwin and Brinkley believe West Success is a useful program.
It was beneficial because I did like extra homework in there, or I would do things that I didn't do the night before for my other classes. So I used that time, so it benefited me.
I sometimes don't always do all my homework at home, and so like West Success is a really good outlet for me to complete any unfinished work, classwork, or study for stuff.
Both Godwin and Brinkley think some students misuse their West success time.
A lot of people do, you know, are able to catch up on their work and stuff, but some people just like sit on their phones or like play around. So I think those people do abuse it.
The teachers, they're supposed to take role, but I think sometimes some students can get away and like go to different classrooms and not really take full advantage of their West success time.
Brinkley hopes West success stays in the schedule for next year.
Like, for me personally, I found it really beneficial, and I think the positives really outweigh the negatives.
I'm Mason Butcher, Wildcat News.
Thanks, Mason. The arts program is coming together this week for a celebration. Emma Pollard looks into it.
The Week of the Arts began on Monday with performances from the Wind Ensemble, Jazz Ensemble, and Symphonic Band. The idea for the celebration came from band director Lucas Mead. He describes his inspiration for the band show theme, Remembrances and Renewals.
You know, this is an interesting time of year because it really is a time where we look at all our seniors and say, you know, I want you to remember and relive and enjoy kind of these last moments and remember everything you've done. But then also go forth and know that you're going to have only bigger and better experiences. And so kind of building a theme around that, and much of our music kind of fits in that. So everything actually ends up tying into one of those other, but I thought it was appropriate given the time of year and what we were trying to do for our seniors.
During the performance, senior Chad Cross conducted an originally composed piece. He explains his feelings about presenting his work.
It was really cool, and like I'm glad I really got to like showcase what I was able to make, and I'm glad that everyone liked it really well.
Cross believes his decision to join the arts program was life-changing.
Then I did marching band, and now like all my friends that I have my best friends are in marching band, and I just have these great opportunities now and like an idea of where I want to go with my life because of the arts.
Mead looks forward to the next two performances of the week.
Mrs. Crabtree's shows are always incredible, and she spends so much time putting together all the work with the students, so I'm excited to see all that. And then Mr. Johnson's first year has been pretty something special, so we're excited to see what he puts together with the star theme. So it's going to be something special, so we hope everyone comes out.
I'm Emma Pollard, Wildcat News.
Thanks, Emma. One of our peers has been recognized for her hard work. Landry Connor sits down with her.
On April 23rd, a banquet was held at Smithfield Selma High School to honor the Johnston County Adult and Student Volunteers of the Year. Senior Summer Lanier represented the school as the Student Volunteer for 2018.
When I found out, I was emailed by Ms. Schwartz, and I was at work, and I just kind of snuck my phone because you don't have your phones out of work, but I snuck it anyway because I got an email. And I looked at it, and I was so excited because I didn't know this was even a thing. And then I found out that I was chosen out of all the students at West Johnston. And I know so many kids that, you know, they do so much in school, like all my friends also volunteer, and that I was chosen out of all the students to represent West Johnston meant so much. And the ceremony they hosted for us, like I got an award, and like there was dinner and all my old teachers were there, and it was just so like nice to see it all pay off.
Lanier explains how she began volunteering her sophomore year.
My freshman year I didn't really do much at school. I wasn't too involved in things. Like I kind of, you know, tried things out a little bit, but sophomore year I really got involved and started volunteering wherever I could and joining clubs and all these organizations, and it makes the experience at high school so much better just to be a part of like something so much bigger than yourself. Once you graduate, like your impact's still there. Like there's still things I've painted at school, and the food pantry will still be there, and like I've worked there so many hours, and it's just like it'll live on kind of through you, what you do for others.
Lanier plans to continue volunteering in the future.
I actually really want to own a nonprofit when I grow up. That's my dream, like above everything else. That's what I want to do for the rest of my life. And I know that in college, I'll find ways to volunteer too. Like I spend every single day at West, like after school, volunteering in some aspect. And so I know I can't just stop doing that. Like it's become a part of my life. I feel like it's what I love doing, what I have to do, and like kind of my, what makes me, you know, me.
I'm Landry Connors, Wildcat News.
Thanks, Landry. Now let's head over to Grayson Betts with the rundown.
I'm Grayson Betts, and welcome to the rundown. Here are the top 10 plays from the 2017 to 2018 sports season. Adriel Rodriguez gains position over his defender.
That's it, up! Up! That's it!
Savannah Kraft gets a rebound and puts the ball back up for the and one. Madison Green sets up Tessa Starkweather for the kill. Jakem Graham fakes his defender and gets to the basket for the and one. Anna Barber catches a foul ball behind the plate. Jakem Graham shakes a double team and finishes at the basket. Josh Harlow makes a diving toss to get the runner out at first.
Oh yeah!
Corey Lawrence scores off a free kick. Megan Boss gets a cross-court kill. Anna Barber gets a triple in an RBI.
Yes, sir! Score!
That's all for the 2017 to 2018 sports season. I'm Grayson Betts, and that's your week's rundown.
Thanks, Grayson. Caroline Carlson asks what teachers have to say to our graduating class.
What is some advice you would give seniors who are graduating?
Get your work done first and then play. I've seen too many people who think they have plenty of time to get the work done and then they don't do it.
Some advice I give to seniors that are graduating is that if you have a chance to travel when you're in college and you can do it on somebody else's dime, hopefully, or somebody else paying for it, get out, go see the world. There's more to the world than JoCo or Raleigh or North Carolina or even the United States. And it gives you a totally new perspective on realizing that no matter where they are, people are the same everywhere you go. They want to have happy families. They want jobs. And it really opens up your mind to the idea that people are just the same and deserve to be treated the same.
I think my advice would be, first of all, to believe that it's okay to not know what you want to do for the rest of your life. But when you choose well. It's kind of more about what you love than it is about the money. So choose really well because you have to do it for a long time. And also that it's okay to be a late bloomer because the most beautiful flowers are often the ones that bloom the lightest.
I would say that if you're going to college, remember that there's so much more to college besides just your coursework. That's super important, but take time to enjoy everything that the college has to offer. And of course, everything in moderation, and that's across the board. So, you know, connect with your community, find new interests, meet new people. Like, I think graduation is just a great opportunity for you to jump off into the next stage of your life and have a chance to reinvent yourself.
Just appreciate every moment because you will miss it one day down the road. Good luck.
Thanks, Caroline. As this school year comes to a close, let's see where our seniors are off to next year.
Celebration. I finally figured out.
thought this day would take an eternity to get here, but as I'm standing here, it seems as if my experience in student media has gone by in the blink of an eye. Every deadline, every episode, every article allowed me to learn new life lessons, meet new people, and share stories that otherwise would have never been told. My face always seems like I don't want to be here, but this place is my home away from home, where I have made so many memories. When I walk into this room, I feel like I have escaped from all my problems and I can focus on what I love. This program has given me a purpose in high school and has allowed me to figure out what I want to do for the rest of my life. Leaving this room, I know that I will continue to strive to be a voice for the voiceless and use what I learned here to make the world a better place. Well, that's all for us this year. If you have any comments, questions, or story leads, email us at wjstudentmedia@gmail.com or send us a tweet at wjstudentmedia. And if you want to watch Wildcat News at home, on the go, or catch up on past episodes, go to wjstudentmedia.com or subscribe to our YouTube channel. I'm Hannah Creech. Thanks for watching, and make sure to check out the bloopers episode next week.